Murang’a Governor Mwangi, Wa-Iria appeared before the Senate Trade and Tourism Committee to defend his hawkers and street vendors bill, which seeks to protect and regulate hawkers and street vendors. Governor Wa-Iria said the bill would reduce unemployment rates as well as expand the tax bracket for government.
But the moment you legitimize it, the number of hawkers will increase, they will be organized, there will be more business, there will be more revenue, and from there, the authority should be able to find means and ways of financing or funding its operation.
In the proposed law, a county vending committee and a national authority shall be established to structure revenue collection from hawkers. A county hawkers tribunal shall also be set up to deal with disputes relating to hawkers' business, and a national bureau to register and manage data for all hawkers.
When you look at the hawkers, when they are being, especially women, and I advocate for women because I'm in the Senate because of the women, I advocate for our hawkers, especially women, who are being harassed with their children on their back. I feel like if I start with this thing, then safety will be found for their livelihood.
When you're talking about free trade in Africa, we must follow our free trade in our seas. There's no way you can achieve free trade in Africa if trade is not free in Kenya.
This bill intends to create order. And that order have accrued benefits. And these benefits includes increased employment, increased tax bracket.
Elsewhere in the National Assembly, Environment Committee put Environment Cabinet Secretary Keriako Tobiko to task over radical changes he has initiated at Kenya Forest Service, where several senior officials were suspended. Tobiko absolved himself from blame, saying the decision was done by the Board of Management. Kevin Washira, Channel News.